Welcome, Katerina. Can you tell us something about your game today?
Well, it was an interesting game, and she probably missed some tactic at some point, and after that point she was already in trouble and got a very difficult position.
Yeah, you've played her many times before. What's your record against Valentina?
I really don't know. We played so many times. I don't want to lose my time to count it, so just game by game.
Right. You have to watch out for her tactics. Was that your plan today, to avoid tricks?
No, the plan is, you know, just to play a good game. If you play good, then you don't really care about tactic or what else. Just, to try to find the best moves possible.
Right, right. Have you recovered from your travelling problems now? Do you feel comfortable now? You've got 2.5 points out of three. You're probably leading the tournament. So how do you feel?
I feel quite okay.
Okay.
I'm looking forward for the next games.
Okay. Thanks very much, Katerina.
Welcome.
Okay, Katerina, let's have a look at some positions from your game today.
Yeah, so today I choose Kensington. Usually I play Grünfeld, more often Grünfeld, but today I decided to change a little bit. So, and Valentina, she chose the line that she didn't play so much before. So usually she plays with knight f3 and castle, but well, she had some games here, so...
I don't think anyone's played this move very much before. It's not very usual, is it? Bishop e3.
This? No. Nowadays, everything is usual. No, I mean, knight c6 is...
Oh, I see, yeah.
Well, there are already many games, but it's still quite new, let's say.
Okay.
So, and as I didn't play it before, it came like a surprise, probably. So, yes, she chose the principal line d5, knight d5. So, there are a lot of complications after f4 and knight g4, but let's forget about it.
Yep.
Yeah. So she played normal knight f3 move, so knight g4, bishop d2. Well, somehow also, as I didn't expect this line, I started to think over the board from, I think, this moment. And, well, I decided to play here to e6, to make clear something with the center.
Yes.
So, of course, many possibilities from both sides. So she chose to take, then f4,
and
yes.
Then f4, f4 to, yes.
She wanted to have this structure, but well.
I think okay. King's Indian players like this structure, don't they? It's like the four pawns attack or something.
Well,
unless you get mated, you feel very comfortable.
Yes. No, I was. It looked for me pretty fine.
Yeah.
It's pretty much fine. So she castle, but also fine for white as well. So
yeah.
Nothing really special. Bishop e3, bishop b7, but she played very fast. Queen c2. Well, there was always a question: should I play knight c5 immediately here, or she just... There is before and here, as the rook is on a1,
yes.
I can try to take and to take here, but well, I was not sure about these dark squares.
Yes.
So I decided to play queen a7, because otherwise the best place for the queen is on a7, so it doesn't matter. So rook in d1. A5. So, because after knight c5, there was before.
Yeah, so
a3. A3, knight c5, and here is a critical moment of the game, because she could play just something simple like bishop bishop f3. Yes, of course, again, there is a question, can I take here
and snatch a pawn on e4?
Well, probably here she takes with a pawn, but maybe I can play e5.
Oh.
Yes, but she also has a 5. Well, I was not sure about this position, but I would play bishop f3 on her side. But she played like, you know, tempo before. She even didn't think, probably a minute, maybe less. So that's why maybe she missed just rook a3 move.
Yes,
but it's very
strong.
Typical
yes.
of this kind of ideas. So that's why I was a bit surprised that she started to think here. Well, the point is, of course, that the bishop is also hanging. So what to do? There was bishop d4, but then I can take, take, and I can play e5. And then to put my knight on e6 is a good square.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
yes. It's another nice position for a King's Indian player.
Yes.
The knight can going to e6. Sorry.
Yes. And also she could play bishop d2, but there is another jump, knight b3, and the knight goes on d4. That is also very unpleasant.
Okay. Yes.
So, and well, she cannot do anything. So e5 was like forced already.
Okay.
And here I wasn't sure because I wanted to play knight e4 when I calculated all this. So takes,
take,
takes. Looks like so to sacrifice a pawn, but I thought it's a very good compensation. But still, that I didn't like that here is her move. So I need to play bishop. I lose the tempo with bishop a8.
Okay.
So that's why I
preferred to do it.
Yes.
From the knight to a4.
Knight a4 is different. If she takes, I take, take, take. She takes this pawn instead of. But here is my move.
It's your move, yeah.
Yes, and there are some jumps. There's rook c3, somewhere bishop e4, or queen a7, or maybe here queen c7 was possible, and to put her knight out of the board, and then to, well, I feel
just,
that bishop e4, and then queen a7, so it's, well, I think it's just.
You've got a lot of freedom, to a lot of
it's
ideas.
Good, very
really.
Good compensation,
yes.
at least.
Yes.
So
okay.
that's why queen d2, yes, rook a3, he takes d6. Well, okay, here I could also take with the, how could I play also? There was something else. Well, okay, let's say queen d7, she took here. And maybe it was better for me to keep the queens. I don't know. Because with this rook a2 always coming. But I was also not that sure because she can play b5. And
the queen is cut off.
So. Yes, a bit. And I, if I play rook a2, then she has queen e3 and the pawn e6 is also a bit hanging. So it's tricky.
She can play for tricks. And
yes.
Valentina likes to play for tricks.
Always. So, that's
so
why,
it's safest to take off the queens. Yeah. The computer
liked
very much
it.
Like
okay.
your position.
Okay. But and after bishop g4, was it correct? Bishop
yes.
Bishop c8.
Yeah.
And okay. You, here I don't have a lot of choice because
no,
I have to... She has already two pawns, so
it's forced
even
move.
If it's
yeah.
double, but it's still two pawns.
Yeah.
So bishop c8, rook d8. Here again, rook
forced
c8
move.
Is coming,
trick,
so
yeah.
king f7 also forced. Okay, I didn't see for her anything else.
No, I think the
rook
computer's
e1,
given
once
up.
Once again, a trick with rook c8, so
yeah.
to exchange
the rooks. Yeah.
So also force, take, take. Maybe after c5, queen e7 wins immediately. This was, I was not sure because here, the point is that she's not on time to do it because of check.
Okay.
So, and she also,
yeah.
She never, after queen, king e7.
Sorry, king e7, yeah.
And all the tricks with the, this also doesn't work because of check.
Same problem.
Yes, same problem. But king e7, I calculate rook d1, then maybe I can take here. Okay, let's say that she takes, I take. Rook e8, king d7, she takes, I take here. Okay, rook b8, yeah, should be easy winning e5. And
I think it's probably everything wins.
Everything wins, okay.
More or less after.
But bishop e6
yeah,
is also solid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rook d1. So same trick with bishop d4 check. Takes b5. Bishop d4. Okay, ugly move, but what to do? Rook king h1.
Yes.
King e7. b6. King d6. Well, I thought that probably the only way to continue the game would be to play rook b1.
Rook and b7 and hope maybe opposite bishops one day.
Yes.
On a good day.
Yes, I can take here.
Yes.
Maybe that's why she didn't play. But then bishop f3 and here.
The game would have lasted a lot longer. Okay, yes, you can maybe do that.
Probably I go to the same endgame, mm-hmm. Yes.
So yeah.
She's not on time, just taken. King c6. So,
yeah, she has to get this move in. And then
yeah, so she also tried
yeah.
a new last trick. The point was, so if I take here, then she can take on e6.
Oh, okay.
And if I take, she has check. And who knows?
Okay. Thank you very much then, yeah. Katerina.